Welcome to CSE Guru. In this session, we will discuss about how to compute closure of I. Already, we have discussed LR of 0 items. So, to compute canonical collection of LR of 0 items, first step is we need to add augmented grammar for the given grammar. Second step is compute closure of item set. Third step is perform go-to operation. So, augmented grammar in the previous session, already we have discussed. Now we will discuss the second step to construct canonical collection of LR of 0 items, that is closure of item set. So item is nothing but adding a dot in the RHS of the production. If I is a set of items for a grammar G, then closure of I is the set of items constructed from I with the help of two rules. Initially add every item in I to closure of I. If A derives alpha dot B beta is in closure of I, and also there is a production B derives gamma, then add the item B derives dot gamma, that is adding dot in the right hand side of the production to closure of I, if not already. So here if you are considering, if there is a production A derives alpha dot B beta, that is after the dot, if a non-terminal is there, means for the productions that starts with this non-terminal, we need to add dot production in the right hand side. That is the meaning. So apply this rule repeatedly until no more items to be added to closure of I. So now we will discuss an example to understand better. Now consider the grammar x derives xb or a. So for this given grammar, we need to compute closure of I. So the first step in all LR parser is, first we need to add an augmented grammar for the given grammar. So augmented grammar is nothing but adding a new production with the help of the start symbol. That is, here start symbol is X. So adding a new production, X dash derives X to the given grammar. So add the new production, X dash derives X, and the remaining productions in the grammar as it is we can write, that is X derives XB or A. So this is nothing but the augmented grammar. Next we need to compute closure of I. So closure of I is simply adding a dot in the RHS of the given production. So here if we are considering, so for the first production we need to add a dot in the RHS. So first production is X dash derives X. So here we need to add a dot in the RHS of the production. So if you are considering, after the dot a non-terminal is there. So for this non-terminal productions, we need to add a dot production. So here there are two productions for this non-terminal X. X derives XB or X derives A. So we need to add a dot production for those two productions. So X derives dot XB and X derives dot A. So this is nothing but closure of I. So here also if you are considering, after dot a non-terminal is there. So for all the non-terminal productions of X, we have added the dot. After dot, if a terminal is there in the sense, no problem. And after the dot, if a non-terminal is there in the sense, for these non-terminal productions, again we need to add the dot. So this procedure continues until there is no more non-terminal productions to add the dot. So likewise, we need to continue. So this is nothing but a closure of I. One more example we will discuss. So next example is, consider the grammar S derives AA or BAC or DC or BDA and A derives B. So for this given grammar, we need to compute closure of I. So first step is, we will implement augmented grammar. So augmented grammar is, for the start symbol of the grammar, we need to add a new production. Here start symbol is S. So we need to add a new production, S dash derives S. And the remaining productions in the grammar, we can write as it is. That is, S derives AA or BAC or DC or BDA, and the next production is A derives D. So this is the augmented grammar. So for this augmented grammar, we need to compute closure of I. So closure of I is nothing but, so for the first grammar, we need to add a dot. So here if you are considering S dash derives dot S. So here we have added a dot in the RHS of the production. So S dash derives dot S. Now after this dot, a non-terminal is there. So for all the non-terminal productions that starts with S, we need to add a dot. So here, if you are considering S derives AA, S derives BAC, S derives DC, S derives BDA. So for all these productions, we need to add a dot in the RHS. So S derives dot AA and S derives dot BAC and S derives dot DC and S derives dot BBA. So for all the non-terminal productions, yes, we have added dot in the RHS of the production. So we need to consider all these productions. In these productions, suppose if after the dot a non-terminal is there, for that productions also we need to add a dot. So if you are considering these four productions, here the first production S derives dot A. So here the non-terminal A is there. So for the non-terminal production A also, we need to add dot in the RHS. So there is only one production that starts with A. So A derives dot B. So now we have added, for the A production also, we have added dot in the RHS. So the remaining productions, if you are considering after the dot, only a terminal symbol is there. So this is nothing but closure of I. So closure of I is nothing but, initially we will compute augmented grammar, because for implementing SLR parser, LALR parser and CLR parsers, first step is we will add the augmented grammar. So we have added the augmented grammar here. So with the help of this augmented grammar, we have implemented this closure of I. For this augmented grammar, for the first production, we need to add a dot in the RHS. In the RHS, we need to consider after the dot, if a non-terminal is there in the sense, that non-terminal, for all its productions, we need to add a dot in the RHS. In those productions also, after dot, if a non-terminal is there in the sense, for those non-terminal productions, again, we need to add a dot. So this procedure continues until there is no more non-terminal productions. So this is nothing but closure of I. So now in this session, we have discussed about how to compute closure of I. In the next session, we will discuss about how to perform go-to operation with the help of this closure of I. Thank you for watching this video.